to offer.
Oh, yeah.
I do! Say, George, can you step forward with the rings? You can come forward like that, okay? Two rings will be taken from you, and you'll just take a step back, okay? And then I'll say, George, can we have the second ring? You'll step forward again. This ring will disappear, and then you can take your seat, all right? But I don't want you worrying about any of that, because I'm going to tell you what to do as we go through, all right? But your most important job right now is to make sure that these rings stay on this pillow all the time you're in there, all right? Okay? George, can you step forward with the rings? You can come forward like that, okay? Two rings will be taken from you, and you'll just take a step back, okay? And then I'll say, George, can we have the second ring? You'll step forward again. This ring will disappear, and then you can take your seat, all right? But I don't want you worrying about any of that, because I'm going to tell you what to do as we go through, all right? But your most important job right now is to make sure that these rings stay on this pillow all the time you're in there, all right? Okay?
You're right. My mummy walks down the aisle. Stand up, yeah?
So, ladies and gentlemen, hello, good afternoon. My name's Adrian. I'll be looking after the ceremony for Vicki and David today. Just a little bit of housekeeping, if I may, before we start. The bride and groom respectfully ask that you do not post anything onto social media before they give you the nod a little bit later on, okay? But even though we have some professionals here on site doing it, they are happy for you to take some photographs, if you wish, from your seats on your phones. Now, if you are using your phones, or indeed if you're not, please can you make sure that they're switched down to silent, okay, so there won't be any interruptions during the ceremony. Okay, but other than that, we're about to begin, okay, so please enjoy yourselves, okay? Are you ready?
Nope.
Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who are able, please be upstanding for the arrival of the bridal party. Who gives Vicky's hand in marriage?
I do.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Thanks, mate. You've got. You should be in one of those seats there. There. Oh, thank God for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. And on behalf of the Nottinghamshire Registration Service, and of course, much more importantly, on behalf of David and Vicky, a very warm welcome to Carr Bank on this very special occasion. And Vicky have chosen to exchange rings, an ancient and traditional way of sealing the marriage vows. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle symbolising everlasting love, and is the outward sign of the lifelong promises that are being made to each other here today. And I have a right-hand man here today, George, who's looking after the rings. If you want to come forward, George, please.
Bless him.
With that hello.
Good
fantastic.
Okay. Absolutely amazing.
And would you like to take the rings?
I'm just going to take that one, mate, okay? You need to look after that one for me.
If you'd like to... Finger of Vicky's left hand. And say these words after me. You're saying them to Vicky.
Yep.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
Of our love.
And our marriage.
And David, you'd like to make a promise to Vicky.
Wrote this down and everything last night. I promise to love you, cherish you, comfort and care for you, honour and protect you throughout our lives together, and this is my commitment to you.
George, could you step forward this time?
Good lad.
So if you'd like to take the ring intended for David. Thank you, George. You take the finger. Okay. And if you place that onto the third finger,
this one.
His left hand. That's right. And push it all the way down. And just hold it there, Vicky. As you say, David, I give you this ring.
David, I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
Of our love.
And our marriage. And Vicky, you'd like to make a promise too.
I promise to love and cherish you, comfort you, and care for you, honour and protect you throughout our lives together. And this is my commitment to you.
David and Vicky will now make a binding contract of marriage to each other. To support them in this, for those of you who are able, please stand.
Hey, baby.
Okay, so you turn and face each other. David, if you could repeat these words after me, please, and you're saying them, of course, to Vicky.
Yep.
I, David Paul Lawrence. Take you, Vicky Louise Lawrence. To be my wedded wife. Vicky. I, Vicky Louise Lawrence. Take you, David Paul Lawrence. To be my wedded husband. David and Vicky, this is the start of a new chapter in your lives together. We hope that the feeling of love that you clearly have for one another will deepen and grow stronger throughout the years to come. You have declared your commitment in the presence of your family, your friends and witnesses, and have made solemn and binding promises. You have symbolised your marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. It is therefore with the greatest of pleasure that I can declare that you are legally joined together in marriage as husband and wife. David, you may kiss your bride. Congratulations.
Can't hear us at the back, because we're deaf.
Are you okay, baby?
Right, there is three speeches, and we're going to start off with Craig, who's the oldest son of the team.
Yeah, good Craig!
If there's any swearing, I will apologise.
It's not bad, I promise.
You're right, team.
It took me 10 minutes. Here it is. Two pages, by the way.
What? Two pages? I'm doing well.
Hi, everybody. Are we all okay?
Yeah!
Yeah, we got two of them. Just want to thank everybody for coming. You all look lovely. Well, most of you do, some of you don't. But, you know. I just want to say, Mum, you look absolutely beautiful. I just want to thank you for giving me this honour of walking down the aisle today. Unfortunately, Grandad's not here. And, that was his job, but just so you know, we can see you, he loves you so much. Dave. Sorry, it's not all that bad, mate, I promise you. I think you're a nice bloke. In fact, I think you're a top bloke. You play rugby, so it's a bonus.
Yeah, it is.
You make my mum happy, that's all I can ask for, so thank you. Anyway, just one more thing. Don't piss her off, mate. She's got a really bad temper. No, I know she's a bit of a hobby, but... Yeah. She's alright. Trust me, I've had my fair share of thrashings, and guess what? Now it's your turn. One more thing, I just want to thank your mum again. I love you. You look beautiful. Dave, welcome to the family. Can I just raise a toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Lawrence? Thank you, and have a good night.
Everyone, come and celebrate the wedding of David and Vicky. David, when you asked me to be your best man, I was honoured, and I get to tell everyone how proud I am of you today. I've never been a best man before, and I'm not renowned for my speeches, speech writing, but I'll try my best, because David said if I do a good job today, I can be the best man at the wedding next to. I didn't really want to say it, but it was still
He put it up to that!
I'll start by telling you about, by far, the better looking one in the relationship, that is Vicky. For the first time in my life, my brother is happy, content and so in love. And I couldn't be happier to see him so settled, and that's thanks to you, Vicky, for bringing out the best of him.
Yes.
I always knew he was there. I always knew it was there. It's just that it just takes a special woman to whip him into shape. It's a joy to have you in our family and to welcome you, and I just think the world of you, Vicky.
All right. Go on, mother. Fucking hell, get on that.
David, my big little brother.
He has a bigger belly.
And some else, mate.
More sexy, mate. More sexy.
Can I start by saying how proud I am? Proud I am of you to call you my brother. David, you've always been there for all the family, and you're willing to do anything for us at the drop of a hat. Especially with you, Vicky. You'll literally do anything for you. And something that every man should take note of is that everything he does for you, Vicky, he does it with a smile on his face. I really am so proud of you, David. So please, can I raise a glass to Mr. and Mrs. Lawrence?
Yes! Mr. Lawrence! Craig, your speech was shit.
So everybody, I wish I can say... Can you shut up, please?
Come on, son.
David, take your
everybody. I wish I could say I could keep this speech short and sweet, but unfortunately I can't.
What do you want?
But I promise you, at the end of the speech it says, P.S. I love you. Right, first of all, I'd like to thank you all for being here to help celebrate mine and Vicky's special day. It means a lot to us, honestly.
No, thank you, mate.
knowing that we've got really such good friends and family. Some of your friends and family who have actually travelled pretty far. Some of them have cut the holiday short in Spain. Someone else, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Some of them who have driven all the way up from Cornwall.
Well done, Chris. This is my space, Chris.
And some of them have had to tag along.
Chris, my space.
See my channel.
Also, the great thing about two people getting married is that the family gets a lot bigger.
Yes, a bit more story.
You know, so it's not only myself and Vicky.
I like it moist, don't we, dog?
Come on, give us a break, this is really hard. So not only is it myself and Vicky that have united our love, but we've united two very special and very big families together, and we couldn't be more happier. But the future parties are going to be very messy.
If you mind, you.
Daniel's name not on it.
I would also like to thank a special lady. Well, I think I could call her special. That lady is called Jackie. Jackie, put your hand up so people know who you are. Where
are
you?
Oh, Jackie!
There you are.
Jackie!
Because, Jackie, if it wasn't for you messing with me, telling me to get my arse up to Mansfield for a drink, we wouldn't be here today. So I thank you, I think.
He's playing Saturday night, don't worry. Is it?
Stop.
I would like to thank my family for all the support you have given me over the years, even though I haven't been the easiest man to deal with. But a special thanks go to my mum. Not only just for being my mum, but she's played both roles of being mum and dad. So thank you so much. I would also like to thank my mum, because my mum's ahead of my family, to welcoming Vicky into our family as well. Yeah. I love you, mum. You're the best. Thank you so much.
I love you too. First base,
yeah.
Is that first one? Yeah.
I would like to thank Vicky's family, all of you, for making me feel welcome.
Well,
I've
been welcome, you
maybe
have to deal with.
I love you all to bits, and it's an honour that I'm now officially a part of your family.
You're always one savage, mate. You always one day. Maybe a lot of time. Mate, look at me, that's all that matters to us, brother. You're a savage, mate. Come on, get over the ground, that guy.
Right on the other side.
No. 100%.
The bridesmaids and the flower girls, wow, don't they all look beautiful?
Yes.
They're absolutely beautiful. And thank you all for being there, for making sure Vicky actually turns up. My groom's party. Thank you all for the help and putting up with the constant messaging.
Yeah.
The texts, you know, the phone calls, it means a lot to me. But don't worry, the next drink's on me. Oh, yay. I said groom's party, goodbye party, don't you think?
You're by your own.
You just start.
I would like to thank the staff. They've done amazing. A special thanks goes to Jordan. Oh my God. Mate.
Yes, Jordan.
What a great. What a brave, polite, and very
patient man you have been. Thank you for putting up with the, you know, the constant phone calls, the bickering, you know.
That will definitely do stay.
Well, I promise, yeah. I promise you this, Jordan, from me to you, for the rest of the day, my phone's hiding, you won't see but anything else.
Drinks on day ball now, Jordan.
Second. Yay! Yeah. On a serious note now, I'd like to take this opportunity to say a few things about two very special and important people who are regrettably not here with us no more. Firstly, Vicki's dad Keith. Now, unfortunately, I didn't have the pleasure of getting to meet your dad, Vicki. And that's one of the things that I do regret. But I really hope he approves of me.
He
would. And he's up there right now when they're drinking us. The second person is my grand Jean.
Come on.
A special lady in mine and my family's lives who I wish was here. As even though it's winter and it's cold outside, to me, she always made everywhere feel warm. And has so much love for all of us. And I know she would have just loved you, thank you so much.
Yes!
So on that little note, I'll be very grateful just for this bit, if you would raise a glass with me, to Keith and Jean.
Keith and G.
Thank you. You're going to
keep
quiet
or speaking?
I'm apparently, those blokes
are
going
to multitask. That's what she said. I don't
know
if you want the situation to
change,
but you've got to come on.
Now.
Keep the ball, mate. Come on, keep the ball.
Now, my beautiful Vicky. Every day, we all do millions of things. A day, which for some reason we all forget. But the one thing I'll never forget is seeing you for the first time wearing those black sport bottoms with a black t-shirt. Unfortunately, say you clip them on it. You looked and smiled at me, and I knew then that you're going to be someone special in my life. And here we are today.
Yeah! Get up! Come on! Everyone! Get up! Oi, you soon suck! Get up!
He's finished here. So, everybody. So, from that day, I used to count the stars in the sky. And now I count them from in your eyes.
Oh.
It's like being in an aura, just being with you. And I count myself the luckiest man on earth that I get to call you now my wife for the rest of my life. Meeting you not only gave me a buzz, but gave me a new purpose in life. And being able to call you my wife is a pleasure and honour. And as always, my heart will belong to you now and forever. You have embraced my son George as one of your own, and nothing could give me more love and affection and more than I do for you right now.
George is
fine.
Where
is it?
Where is
our George?
Shout George. George,
do you want to come up here, mate?
You've got to do it. 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 You
I think this picture right here, can, we can all agree that a blended family really can work. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, Vicki, we could both agree it hasn't been the easiest of rides, but like we have always said, as long as we have each other, then nothing can stop us. And all of us here being here today proves that. That with hard work, love and teamwork. So thank you, Vicki, for putting your trust, life and love in me. And I promise I will love, cherish and protect you forever. So on that note, would everyone please help me and raise a glass to my love, my best friend, and now forever my wife, Vicki Lawrence. The is nearly the end, yes, thank God.
The end credits.
Yeah, the end credits.
Yes.
That was nice in the first one.
So everybody, on that note,
and there's
it. I hope you all enjoy the rest of the evening. I hope there's lots of drinks involved. Plenty.
Adam? No, it's not.
The groom's party, the bride's party, we do have gifts for you as a thank you, because it means a lot that you've helped us, okay? So we will find you during the course of the night and give you your gifts, okay? Everybody, the bar staff, thank you very much personally, you've been brilliant. I do apologise now for that little guy, because it's a bit cheap when he gets drunk, it's likely to get that.
Okay.
I apologise for my mother because she likes the Prosecco, she'll probably drink you dry, but hey, oh shit happens. But on that note...
Don't like it.
But on that note, everybody...
You told me you were your sister!
Oh, I am!
But on that note, thank you all for coming, I love you all to bits, and then from the rest of the evening, let's get pissed.
Goodbye, oh no.